It's Mike here, one go short play. Putting voices on my second video. Cyberpunks for the Commodore Amiga. Yeah, nerve-wracking experience this, recording my voice while I play the game. When I'm talking to myself, it's much easier and much less nerve-wracking, I have to say. Let's see. Make a new system. Mission 1, another bug hunt. Listen up, 5501st Cyber Assault Squad. Right. Giant alien biocrawler taking over terraform colony base asteroid B14 orbit round forbidden. Okay. Whatever that said. I think I remember this. Top down, character based shooter. I think I had a dodgy copy of this once a while ago. Yeah, this is familiar. Haven't played it since, what, 94? Okay, so we're running around. We're shooting stuff. We're here. We can do this. Oh, yeah, and you can make little lines of death like that, which is kind of useful. Okay, we haven't yet met. Hello. I'm guessing that you're not friendly. Yeah, I thought not. The screen said it. Right. Let's see. Down to business. Ah. That's what we need, is it? Okay. I can handle that. This is not good. Sneaky little ninja lady. Oh, come on. Oh, didn't seem quite right, did it? Okay, go down. Going down. What's that? Doesn't look good. Okay, so we're wandering aimlessly until we find a keycard. I'm guessing that is the idea. Did we pick up a keycard? Am I thinking of the thing where it said we needed? That looks like some kind of way in. And there's stuff in there. Oh, it's just a, I don't know what he's about. Unless it randomly spawns them and he's just randomly spawned in the wrong place. Those other two guys with me are doing zero damage to the baddies. Is it just me noticing this? So, that whole straight line to make a war of death thing is bobbins. It doesn't work. It doesn't happen. We might as well ignore those two little dudes right now, because they are, for all intents and purposes, utterly useless. We're gonna just pretend it's all about the little red dude. Yeah, I thought I might. Give us a keycard, game. Getting nowhere. Ah, hello. No. Getting nowhere without a keycard. What's that? This. Oh, I see. I'm swapping whatever I've got. Does that mean that the other dudes are there to pick up stuff? Carry stuff? You know. I can't figure out how to get to select them. Oh, hello. Right, I've just selected the green dude. Ah, he's picked something up. I'm getting it. Blue dude. Red dude. Green dude. Blue dude. Okay. Whoa, hello. Yeah, that's what you get. Green dude. Whoa, what's that? But blue dude, green dude, red dude, robo dude. Ah, oh, these little green things are. Get off from me. Right, it looks like they don't die, except of their own accord. We can handle that. It's kind of cool. It's not quite the Chaos Engine. I like the big fast sprites though. Chaos Engine obviously is the kind of nearest well-known game to this sort of format. And I can see a bit of influence from that in this, I think. That did come well after, didn't it? But it doesn't quite have the. And you know, it breathe and whatnot. It doesn't quite have the intensity. It doesn't quite have the sense that you're in a designed environment. It's all a bit. Walk around for long periods of time until you either run into one of those or just get bored and turn it off. And I think this is how I remember it. From when I was a teenager as well, as like, actually this is a bit dumb. But I'm going to stick it out, at least till the 10 minutes, or until I find a flipping key card, or something weird happens like that. What was that? Oh, I see. That's like a teleporter. Oh, do it again. I know what's going on now. Right, okay. That was up there. Excuse me. I have got a proper dodgy throat. I don't know why I started talking about these things today, of all these. Right, that's blue. And that's red, I see. So, hello, been looking for you. Oh, please tell me you picked that up. Oh, I didn't. Okay, so, blue teleporters mean you're going somewhere. Red teleporters mean you're coming from somewhere. You can't step on a red teleporter and expect to go back. Gotcha. So, if you get it wrong, you've got to find the original blue teleporter and get back there via that. Okay, so the blue guy is selected. We'll walk over it with the red guy. Yes, though. Ooh, hiccups. The blue guy has picked up the key on the blue teleporter to that red teleporter. Ah, now we're getting it. Okay, oh, that's what the... That's why you can't get in there. It all makes sense now. Okay, right. That means I can open this door. And it looks like there's only one key. Ooh, hello, a disc. In the level. Which means open that door. There's another door in the corner. This key must open everything. It's actually a bit faster to go diagonally. Oh, no! No, alright. It used up the key. But what was the green disc about? The green disc might give us something to go and open somewhere. Green disc, what have we got? We've got a green disc. We've got... Oh, that's like health. No, oh, shouldn't we? Using the key up on that stupid door. Really? Really? We've now... Is that like game over now? But it's not telling you. Because you've picked up the key, used it in the wrong place, and that's it. Hello. Sell me keys. It's all a bit alien breed. Welcome to Matrix Series. Yeah, test the RAM on your own time. Come on. Disc full. Oh, I don't care. Oh, disc will. I don't care. I want a key. Now, that one was a green key. Bypass door circuits. It's got me there. Unless I... Have I bought a key? Or those bypassed green doors? Oh, no. All door circuits. Ooh, force fields are not affected by its operation and are still active. I didn't see any force fields. Did you see force fields? New deck blueprints. We don't need to new deck blueprints. We've opened the doors, apparently, to everything. Why didn't I see that before? Okay. So in theory, there's two doors over here. One's on the right at the top. One's on the right at the bottom. And oh look, they're open. I'm not going in there yet. I want to see what's in this door. And that's all this effort. Just to bypass that little room and only see goodness and kill that little dude. Yes. And I got a little red disc. Do I even want to bother with this? Is it going to be... Oh, no, really? Come on. Come on, skip. I just don't want any of that. I don't even care to read it. I want to get to the lift on the next level. Oh, yes. Yeah, so it's quite good, this. It's no alien breed, it's no chaos engine, but it's got a nice visual style to it. Alright, so much later than those two games, it's like 194, so it should be better and it should look nicer. I wouldn't say it looks nicer, I quite like the big sprites, and I quite like the three character thing, although I'm not really sure it's being used to its potential, but maybe the... You can equip the other characters with better guns and actually give some sort of fight to them. Who knows? Okay. And it's a bit difficult to tell what you can pick up and what you can't. You know what? This has also got visually something of that Zombies Ate My Neighbors kind of game look to it. You know where... Ooh, that was cool. You know where everything's a bit cartoony of it. It would fit in that style if there were trampolines and zombies. Now that is what I call a force field. Or what I'm guessing it calls a force field. Green. I want that, Okay. And now our bags are almost full with stuff we don't know how to use. Right, hello. You die. See, what's that about? That looks usable for something and it's not. It's just background noise. Really? Blue. Okay. It was blue. Dead dude. Oh. Hello. It's alright though. It's fairly compelling. If not amazingly brilliant. Yeah. That is Cyberpunks, Commodore Amiga. Thanks for watching.